The officials for tonight's game. On the left, Charles Vaca. In the middle, Bruce Shapiro. On the right, Charles Watkins Jr. All veteran NCAA officials who've worked games in several conferences this year. And again, they are involved in a tournament of sorts themselves. For after they work these games, their work will be evaluated. Those who do best will go on until finally the best of them all, the cream of the crop, winds up the final four in New Orleans. Matchups tonight. Essentially, Michigan is a three-guard offense. Antoine Joubert is called a forward, but he's a guard. That will give Navy some matchup problems, but then Michigan has matchup problems against the guy everyone calls the battleship. David Robinson will jump center against Hughes. A capacity crowd filling up here quickly in the Charlotte Coliseum. Navy controls. Navy scores.
How about that?
Right off the tap.
Reese is a streak shooter. They claim his first shot indicates everything. And as a result of that one bounce layup, there have to be a lot of reasons for Pete Herman to be smiling.
Now that story says a lot right there. Michigan, remember, last Saturday, walloped Purdue.
It was their 500th Big Ten victory, and it was impressive. But we have to remember on Wednesday night, they got hammered at home by Illinois.
Rice can't connect, and Robinson controls.
Michigan's a very erratic team from game to game and from half to half, but they have tremendous firepower. Four different players have gone for 30 points in a single game, so they can do it.
Navy on a 13-game win streak. David Robinson set his career high in Kentucky at Rupp Arena in a performance that earned him a standing ovation from the 20,000-plus Kentucky faithful. And ever since, Navy has been on a roll. They say because in a team meeting, the players told Robinson, David, you don't have to carry us. We want you to look to us to shoot the ball. And that's what made a difference for them. Until later in the season, there was a time when this man was on the bench in foul trouble. And not only did the reserves hold things pat, they actually increased the lead.
Look at this, 7 feet tall. Look at the shooting stroke. Tremendous backspin.
Let's see if he misses the second. Got into that habit. Nope, made them both. Last year, at one point, Bucky got into a habit. He'd make the first free throw beautifully, and then he'd miss the second.
Well, he's a 64% free throw shooter, but the stroke looks so much better than that. Maybe zoning, but it's active. Interesting, it's a 2-3, and Robinson is not in the middle. He's on the left wing.
Joubert can't get the three-pointer. Michigan looks a little confused, Bucky. Here's Wojcik, the general for Navy, if you will, or the admiral. Michigan controls. Grant gets their first bucket of the night. Now, we should tell you, one of the critical reserves for Michigan, Mike Griffin, didn't even suit for tonight's game. He's back at the hotel here in Charlotte. He's sick. So he has not suited tonight.
And Michigan is already very thin at the forward spot. Navy, on the other hand, has been playing up to 10 men. So Pete Herman has developed his bench through the course of the year. But, of course, the only one anybody remembers is David Robinson. Defensive field goal percentage, that is a valid defensive statistic, much more so than the number of points per game the defense gives up. That's a tempo statistic.
Mark Hughes loses the ball out of bounds. It'll be Navy's ball. Hughes has both fouls now, both of Michigan's first two fouls. He's trying to play Robinson, and he's having his problems early.
Yeah, that's a large fraternity, frankly. Guys that tried to play him and had problems.
Yeah, they can have a heck of a meeting. They need a big hotel. There's another big shot from Reese. He's got four. Robinson has four, and Navy leads by six.
Oh,
Michigan coming into this game, this is how they did against teams in the NCAA field this year. Remember, they finished fifth in the Big Ten. Navy, the Colonial Athletic Association champion and the tournament champion.
Robinson now not in the middle on the back of that zone as we talked about earlier. Good move inside. Grant makes the move, draws the foul. Basically, he was lucky to get out of there because I'm not sure where that ball would have gone except maybe down his throat because a half a step behind him was Robinson in pursuit.
He must have got him with a body because that was a clean block. Substitution early for Michigan. 35, Loy Vaught into the game. In place of the man with two fouls, Mark Hugh. So Vaught, primarily a forward, will move into center.
He's been the leading scorer off the bench for the Wolverines, but he's overmatched today coming into the center spot. What a time to try to pick up a few defensive center skills when you're looking at number 50 in the white.
Yeah. Carl Liebert. This is Anton Jaubert with the ball. Michigan hits. Two-pointer, they say. Two for Grant.
So far, the styles and trends have held up. Navy pounding the ball down inside. Michigan going for the perimeter shot.
There's Robinson again. Pretty jumper. I remember seeing him very early in what was his freshman year. He was about 6'8", real gangly, skinny kid. And you said, well, he's going to be an all right forward. You know, he's never going to set the world on fire. And then all of a sudden, David Robinson grew like a flower overnight, 7 inches. And more important than just the growth, Bucky, is he did his work. He lifted the weights. Take a look at the shoulders and the arms on him the next time he goes to the foul line. You'll see how big he really is. And right now, he's big for the Navy. He's got 8 points.
I'm intrigued with the defense, the fact that he's not playing the middle. He's playing that left side, which indicates that Michigan's tendency would be to attack from the right side, which would leave him in the high percentage rebound area. We'll see if that holds up.
12-4, it's an 8-point lead for Navy. I'm a little surprised that they got out this quick.
Boy, it's great pressure on Wojcik. Grant is a fine defensive player.
Side, and this time it's Derek Turner with his first field goal.
Robinson is scoring on jump shots, and when he comes out of the middle of that defense, he takes a crowd with him.
Bill Frieder's got to stop things. He's got to do something to stop the Navy onslaught. There's a timeout on the floor with the score. Michigan 4, Navy 14. It's 31 seconds into this basketball game, and Bill Frieder has already called a timeout. The scoreboard says why. He hasn't figured out what to do yet with Navy. He's got a problem. In the paint, Navy has outscored Michigan 10-0.
Number 10, Doug Wojcik, the 6'2 senior from Wheeling, West Virginia. He's the guts of this team. He's more than just a captain. He's a relentless competitor, very deceptive player, but he's so critical. He already has 2 assists tonight, finding David Robinson in the paint. And if he can master the pressure and stand up to the onslaught of defensive pressure and deliver the mail down inside, Navy's going to the next round. There's that much pressure on him. Still in a 2-3. The midshipman.
Again, the 3-point shot. This time, Grant connects.
Coming out of the timeout, they go right for it. But there's one thing about that style of play. It's not going to put any defensive pressure on the center, David Robinson.
There he is. Oh, my goodness. Bring the rafters down with that one.
Well, for you golf fans out there, there was a divot in the floor after that one. I mean, we're talking serious spike here.
Woo, Thompson with a 3-pointer. Look, they're coming right back. That's guard Thompson's first shot. Michigan did spend a lot of time before the game, 90 minutes before the game, shooting jumpers, lots of jumpers. But the old adage, Bucky, I always heard was you live by the jumper and you die by the jumper.
Well, I think it's critical, though, that they won't be putting any pressure on Robinson inside, and that's certainly a key. You've got to think about going at him.
There's Liebert to score. So Navy, which worried about balance scoring coming into this game, has gotten points and field goals from everybody on the team except Wojcik. Four of the five starters have scored. And there's their shooting. 11 shots to Michigan's seven. It looks like Michigan's only going to get one shot tonight, too.
Well, they're firing and falling back. Chuck and Duck, as we talked in the second game. Nobody on that offensive board.
Make that move!
Liebert, they call him for the walk. All right, let's look for the little tuft of grass to tip up on the divot on this that you talked about.
Boy, no weak side help at all, and if there was any, the kids at Michigan are bright enough not to get in front of a train. I want to tell you, he nailed that one. I would have played a little Matador defense on that one myself, just kind of shuffled the cape and let the bull go by. He is awesome. He started that slam down above the square.
Wojcik causes the turnover by Michigan. You know, another thing, Bucky, that you mentioned, that this defense that Michigan, or the offense that Michigan is playing, is keeping Robinson out of foul trouble. The other thing it's doing is it's giving him a chance to rest. If Dave Robinson has a weakness so far in his career, it is the fact that he does tire. They rely on him so much. He is so big and has grown so fast that he tends to get fatigued.
Boy, that's a good series for Michigan right there. I'm looking for Michigan to try a little zone. Frieder felt yesterday he was going to have to change some defenses. He's a very good man-for-man coach, but you can't play this club head-up with Robinson.
So far, Grant is carrying the mail. 10 points for Grant of Michigan's 13.
Right, Frank, and on the other end, he's the guy with the contract on Wojcik. He's the one that's supposed to put pressure on him. Some players respond better that way, though. You give them an easy defensive assignment, and they don't play well at the offensive end.
Three-pointer is the answer from Navy.
Well, we got one of those, too.
That's Cliff Reese.
Well, he got the good start. A layoff, a one-bounce dribble off the opening tip. Michigan tried to steal the tip and got caught in their rotation. Superb.
Robinson with a block. Three-point shot by Thompson.
Well, the poise of Michigan coming through that tough Big Ten. You know, a lot of teams might have buckled the way Navy came out of the blocks. I mean, Robinson living up to his clippings. Perfect basketball, 8 for 11. They've kept their cool.
Navy hitting the boards. Robinson already has 12.
It's like the early part of this game is like they took a whole game and did a highlight film down into a few minutes.
You're right.
They can't possibly keep this up.
It's a tremendous pace, and there's another three-pointer by Grant.
Holy mackerel.
It's a fireworks display in Charlotte. Robinson gets hacked. And I think they're going to call Hughes on the foul. If they do, that's three.
All right, the big man coming from the weak side. David Robinson gets a reject. This is a hard stat to believe, but only one team collectively, Louisville, has more blocks than David Robinson has individually. That's close to awesome. Over four a game.
The foul was on Antoine Joubert.
Now Robinson's in the middle. Really interesting. It's too bad we can't communicate with Pete Herman. I'm curious as to why he started on the wing and now in the middle.
There are his statistics already.
Tom Bates, the SID from the Naval Academy, said several of the players told him that David is very ready. I said, what do you mean by that? Well, they can just tell when he's about to give a vintage performance. And they were convinced that tonight would be an awesome Robinson night. And so far, they're fortune tellers.
He gets very quiet. He doesn't come out long for warm-ups. He'll come out late in the warm-ups and stay out for a little while and go back in early.
If I was coaching him, I'd send a limo for him.
He can see him very intense. He's very inward-directed. Turnover so far. Michigan with four, Navy with just one. And off the turnovers, Navy's converted every time off the four Michigan turnovers. They've got 8 points.
I hope they have asbestos nets. If not, we're going to have to change them at the half. tell you this, every time down. If there's any defense out there, it's around the yard. Everybody is going career here.
Carl Liebert with the shot. And we've got a foul away from the ball. The question is, Bucky, could David Robinson be tired right now? You see him bending over, yeah, grabbing his shorts, but he does that. That's a habitual thing.
Well, that's usually a good indicator that they're striving for some oxygen. There really isn't much pressure on him defensively. I don't believe he's tired. I think there's a lot of emotion in this game. I think in a game of this importance, the first round of the NCAA, there's a little nervous drain there, but they quickly come out of that. Navy does have the better bench. They just don't have anybody to replace number 50.
We are midway through the first half, and Navy leading 27-20.
Well, both teams finally starting to make an error or two. Pete Herman, what a year he's had following a tough act.
Oh, this has been a pressure year for him. Everyone expected him to do very well.
Both of these coaches really in difficult years. Bill Frieder, after two straight Big Ten titles and a marvelous successfully rebuilding year. And Herman creating his own identity following Paul Evans.
Might have been a foul there, but no one called it. Rice will score.
And he had his tonsils checked, too, because David Robinson was a good 3 feet over him.
Navy still leads by 5.
You know, I think Robinson is a little tired. He's not coming to meet the pass as he did earlier. That was not a great feed in the post that time by Craig Draper. But an earlier David Robinson would have come and gotten it in traffic.
Robinson's already played a game. He has 14 points here in the first half. There's a timeout. Michigan 22, Navy 27. Here are the other scores from around the NCAA tournament so far today. In the Southeast, New Orleans with a surprise over BYU by 4 points. Alabama beats North Carolina A&T in the Southeast. In the Midwest, Xavier upsets Missouri by a point. Duke over Texas A&M. They only scored the 50s today. Slow game. Overtime before Kansas State beats Georgia. It was 72-72 at the end of regulation. Nevada, Las Vegas. Was he worried about Idaho State? Yes, says Jerry Tarkanian. Scared to death. Marshall lost to TCU in the first game here today. And in the second game, Notre Dame, after a closely fought game through most of it, pulled away from Middle Tennessee State. Here, it's Navy by 5 points with 9.5 minutes left to go. Frontline scoring, you see there, David Robinson's got 14 of those 20. Carl Liebert has helped him out with 4 rebounds and 3 assists. Michigan, meanwhile, just 7 points off their front line. But Michigan has hit 3 of 4 from three-point range. The whistle stops play. Pete Herman's upset.
Charlie Vaca came off the baseline to stop action there.
Where it is, a forearm from David Robinson to the back of the head of J.P. Oosterbaum.
So much for the sportsmanship award. That may be the only one David Robinson hasn't won.
Michigan tries again the three-pointer, and they're now 3 for 5 there, and Navy's got a break. Two shots, and he can't hit, and Michigan comes back. Mike Herzog with Bucky Waters in Charlotte Coliseum in Charlotte, North Carolina. Michigan trying valiantly to catch up with Navy. Navy leads it by 5, 27-22. We're still in the first half. You see the clock, 8.5 minutes to go.
Terrific pass by Wojcik. Gary Manhurst just didn't get the handle on it.
Oosterbaum will score.
This game now is degenerated into schoolyard basketball. They're just running and gunning.
That hurts Navy, doesn't it?
Yes, it does. They got to wait for the big fella to set up.
There There he is inside. Hughes is called for the foul. That'll be number three against Mark Hughes. This telecast is presented by authority of the NCAA. Any use of this program without written consent is prohibited. The announcers for this program have been approved and contracted by NCAA Productions. Transportation arrangements provided through Fugazi International Travel, the official travel agency for NCAA championships. Three fouls now on Mark Hughes. So immediately, Michigan has foul problems. Now we know why Bill Frieder was walking around with his tie undone an hour before game time. Derek Turner with another easy bucket. 4 points for him.
Carl Lever, great fake. I'll tell you, Michigan really goes for the ball fake. You show that ball around a basket, it rings blue jerseys. Rice, a great athlete, been kind of quiet. Gets that zone of Navy.
Ustaban inside with a personal foul.
Nate Herman pleased with his defense on that occasion. Now looking at the other end, Robinson wearing two blue jerseys outside of his white jersey. The man does draw a crowd.
You know, Pete Herman probably deserves more credit than he's been given. When he became the head coach of Navy, he lost two outstanding seniors, Kevin Butler, a great inside player, and Kyle Whitaker, a fine shooter. With those two gone, he had to rebuild around David Robinson, much in the same way John Thompson rebuilt Georgetown. Pete Herman went to his bench and said, guys, I want to get a lot of people, a lot of playing time, and it worked. It's part of the key to that 13-game win streak. Meanwhile, guard Thompson hit his third straight three-point shot. He has 9 points. Back comes Navy.
David Robinson turned back into a triple team and just went to the seventh floor. Then went to the ninth floor.
Rebound battle is getting ferocious. And who is it? 24, Derek Turner with his first foul.
Out of bounds. Out of bounds.
Michigan trying to get the high-low dump down. Getting second and third efforts now. Robinson not as dominating on the board as he was early. Tremendous surge of adrenaline for him early. He hasn't yet caught that second win. Navy staying 2-3 with Robinson on that right wing.
Joubert. That's Lever with a rebound. Here's Wojcik looking for something. They were looking for the alley-oop to Robinson. It wasn't there. 3-point shot. Wow, aren't they come back. Reese with his second.
Well, he's right on cue. They said he was streaky. If he gets a good start, he is terrific. And he has lived up to billing.
Navy keeps the 5-point lead. Three-point shooting so far. You see the numbers. Michigan taking 9 shots already from three-point range. Navy has hit 2. Wojcik, who just faked the three-point shot, is their best three-point shooter. Wow. Ustaban will get number 2. The question is, how many big guys can Michigan wear out?
I don't know. He is so quick. Ustaban thinks he has pretty good position. Watch how quickly he turns. He really wanted to nail that one in Ustaban's face. But just the pure bulk knocked him off balance.
Can you wear him down a little bit by just throwing wave after wave of Wolverine at him? Look at him shake his head. Ustaban over there saying, I can't handle that guy.
There aren't that many waves. Michigan just doesn't have that kind of front court depth.
Robinson misses the free throw. He's tired. He has not been out of the game. He's played the whole first half and he's just missed 2. Maybe he needs a rest. Pete Herman sitting over there saying, I don't know. Rice again.
I'll tell you one thing. Navy didn't have to worry about playing defense very long. It's a 1 or 2 pass, and the Wolverines get it up there. So it's not the defensive end that's wearing them out. It's carrying those bodies around.
They forced the bad pass.
Robinson is tired.
Even tired.
A dangerous save. As tired as he was, watch the big guy, number 50, David Robinson, trucking back. Grant sees, he's too far away. This one's safe. Return to sender.
I just look at the fans dressed in Carolina blue over here waiting for North Carolina's 9 o'clock game. They were applauding that one.
They thought they were going to catch that one.
Timeout. Navy has called a timeout. They're going to give David Robinson a rest, and he needs it. With 5:34 remaining in the first half, it's Navy 34, Michigan 31. You're looking live at the Charlotte Coliseum, where Navy at one point enjoyed a 9-point lead. They've seen it whittled down to 3. But they're still leading Michigan, and they have led throughout the first half, thanks largely to the play of one man, David Robinson. Is he Goliath? He is. Fourth in the nation in scoring. Number 4 in the nation in rebounding. First in the nation in block shots. He's the only player in NCAA history to score over 2,500 points, grab 1,300 rebounds, and still shoot 60% from the field. It is very possible, well, he's a leading contender for the Naismith Award this year. In fact, ESPN will have an exclusive report about that immediately following tonight's game.
Started out his freshman year, averaged only 7 points per game. A real inspiration. The hard work.
Hard growing 7 inches.
12 points on 4 shots for guard Thompson. All of them beyond the stripe. Robinson in a crowd, and he still gets a shot. What a great shot. Navy by 2 for the Michigan lead. And he's got it. Michigan can't stop Robinson. Navy can't stop Thompson.
Immediately after the timeout, Navy goes to its strength. The main man splits the double team. Piece of cake. What a touch. I was told that he has been a gymnastics teacher. That boggles my mind. 7'1 gymnastics teacher. Barishnikov, he's not. I mean, he is terrifically agile, but I just cannot comprehend that.
Thompson again from his favorite spot. 6 3-point shots for guard Thompson, the senior guard for Michigan. And he's got 18 to match Robinson for game's high score. Oh, look at that shuttle shot by Robinson. The basket's good. We're going to call goaltending. Bill Frieder up and pacing. You can see him yelling.
He wants a walk. He can't believe that David Robinson made that much turf. 3-point shooting, awesome stats. Frieder got the towel over his shoulder. He chews on it a little bit. Nothing like Tarkanian, you know.
You see 8-for-13 3-point shooting, and man with the ball right there, he's hit 6 of them.
Maybe matching up a little bit now out of that defense.
Rice over Robinson.
And that was an altered shot. With David Robinson looking at him right in the eye, he had to put it back a few clicks.
It does everything but go in.
Close to a charge that time. Robinson's favorite move is to come back into the lane, which makes a lot of sense because it keeps him on the offensive board. If he goes through, we're talking tag team wrestling in there. And it's not one way. Michigan is trying to force him toward the baseline, which takes a little pressure off Robinson coming back on that offensive board. When he puts it up in the middle, he can come back at you and get it on either side of the board.
Here are the numbers on Robinson. 20 points. He's hit 9 of 11 shots from the floor. 2-for-5 at the foul line. And 5 rebounds.
He also has 2 rejects.
Navy's got the ball. Oh, they're going to say off Michigan.
This is not a pretty game.
Frieder is doing everything he can to help his team.
Dean Herman looking very professorial on the other bench compared to Frieder.
I think he's concerned. I think he's concerned about the pace of the game, Bucky. It is pretty fast. Hard tops. That's rare, a two-pointer. He has 20.
Well, he went for 11 for 12, including 8 for 9 in a previous game, so he's capable.
Michigan has hit 6 of their last 6 shots. That's why they're up by 5.
Robinson again in traffic. Very seldom does he punch the ball back out to the open jump shooters. Navy may have to reconsider that, especially if he keeps missing his free throws.
Navy is in the bonus situation.
Michigan's been over 100 8 times this year. That's not a pace that Navy wants to keep.
.23 for David Robinson.
Could be on the pace toward another 45-point game as he pulled off at Rupp Arena against Kentucky. It was 11-point win for Kentucky. The backcourt for Navy had a total of 4 points that game.
Grant the miss. Robinson the rebound. Wojcik, he had the man down court. Didn't get him the ball.
Gary Grant, a guard, rejected that shot.
Wojcik is trapped here now, and Michigan's got the ball. Tripping. Had to make that call. Derek Turner, second personal foul. Make it his third personal foul.
Look at Grant coming from the guard spot. A tremendous athlete at 6'3", coming in to nail that hard against the board. Grant has been a terrific player all season long. He has not played well in NCAA competition. That was something he wanted to prove in this tournament in his junior year. Off to a great start tonight.
Here's an update from around the country. San Diego in the Midwest ahead of Auburn. That's a bit of a surprise. That's still in the first half.
Auburn's another team that can score points in a hurry.
Thompson finally missed a three-point shot. He had hit on 6. Clock shows 2 minutes. You can see it there in the lower right-hand corner.
Carl Liebert, 6'7". When he jumps, you have to get down, look to see if there's daylight under his shoes. He's just a very deceptive player. Plays with his head and his heart.
He and Wojcik held a press conference yesterday and said they had no idea how good and how far this team would go when they went to Navy. Their idea was to go to Navy and have fun and play basketball and serve their Navy commitment and maybe sometime be a coach. I think Michigan's starting to look a little tired now, Bucky.
Well, they're thin on the bench. Let's watch.
Get a little frustrated now.
Yeah, Thompson's been playing so well. That was not a smart foul, certainly, for a senior.
What is it? They start using their hands instead of their feet.
Going after that Captain Hook Award.
Yeah. Navy within one, 44-43, and Liebert at the line, where he shoots 66%.
One and one.
This is a one-on-one situation, as you just heard the referee say.
David Robinson's roommate.
6 points, 6 rebounds, and 5 assists for Carl Liebert tonight.
Get up, get up!
Michigan control. 1:25 to go in the first half. Michigan by 1.
Well, we've been treated to some half.
Grant again.
Navy going man for man. Grant the penetrator using his quickness now.
Kramer with a reach-in foul. pardon, Carl Liebert with a reach-in foul. Kramer, you may notice, is wearing number 34. You Michigan fans know he always wears number 24. The last game, someone swiped his jersey and they haven't returned it. So it's 34 now for Jack Kramer.
Well, the last game was the Purdue game, and I would think that that wouldn't be a problem at all. That's one of those career nights for everybody. Hard to believe that game, especially coming off an absolutely disastrous loss at home to Illinois by 14 in Ann Arbor. Coaches stayed up all night, watched all manner of film. They had some team meetings and heart-to-hearts, and they just blew a fine Boilermaker team away to conclude the regular season.
First 2 points for Kramer, and it's back to a five-point Michigan lead.
Gary Grant still applying full-court pressure to Wilkins.
Shot clock is still on as Robinson gets the shot and gets the foul.
Michigan is just a half a step slow. They know where Robinson is going to go when he takes the feed. He keeps turning back into the middle, and they're trying to get, they know where he's going, but they're getting there just a little late. They almost have to start running as the pass starts in to build that wall to force him to the baseline. Boys, why coaches get gray? Pete Herman in his best Johnny Bench stance over there. Had this man hit his free throws, it would be a different game. However, his getting fouled has put serious pressure on the Michigan bench and their depth.
Michigan going to go for the last shot for the first time.
And Navy's in his zone, which is... Well, it's kind of unusual because you know that the reason Michigan has this lead has been their perimeter shooting. You might think they'd go man for man, try to get a little better coverage.
Pete Herman has set that zone up. His defense is playing right in front of his bench. So that's what he wants. He's calling out instructions now. Derice and Wojcik. Six seconds left to go and a foul.
Navy only averages 77 points a game. The Colonial Athletic Association, not a terribly difficult conference. So you have to figure that 77 with that kind of competition, though they do have a one-point win at Michigan State, they really don't like this high a score against this good a team.
Seconds, two, you see the call there. They won't get it off, I don't think. Nope. It wouldn't have counted if it had gone. Michigan has the last say of the first half. You see the difference there, it's five. That's the end of the first half with a score. Michigan 49 and Navy 44. We'll be back after this message and a word from your local station. This is an NCAA Productions telecast. We're back at halftime. This is the Charlotte Coliseum in Charlotte, North Carolina. I'm Frank Herzog, and joining us here at half court is Captain B.O. Coppage. Bo Coppage, the athletic director at the Naval Academy. First of all, are you a little surprised? Did Bill Frieder come up with a good idea to go against your Navy team?
Yeah, I sure was. In the meantime, I think both teams are playing very well. We always thought Michigan would be an outstanding basketball team, and they are. I think the number of baskets are probably about the same. They have made a lot of three-pointers, and that has put them in good shape. It's I haven't seen David Robinson play much better than he's played tonight. I think it's been an intense competition and very competitive on both teams. I really couldn't find fault. I don't know the turnovers. You might know, but I think they're minimal.
The turnovers that have happened, Navy has taken better advantage of them than Michigan. At last point, I think they'd competed like 8 points on five turnovers. Listen, let me get to something else I want to ask you about. Let's face it. When David Robinson grew 7 inches, the prospects for Navy basketball grew along with him. For years, you guys played service-level ball. Nobody expected any more out of you. Robinson gets this big. You get in the ACC, the NCAA tournament for 3 straight years. You're among the elite, the top 32 teams. Now, when David Robinson leaves,
Where do you want the program to stay? You want it to stay at 32 in that elite group, or are you willing to go back to service ball?
Well, Frank, I think we're going to try to stay at the competitive level we are at the present time. Certainly, we've been very fortunate to have David. He has attracted other good people. But I think that in this environment that we're in the country, that everybody's interested in a quality education. Certainly, we have the best education. Our number of applicants have never been at a higher level than they are at the present time. So we think we can get basketball players that'll be competitive. We certainly probably won't get another Robinson, who has one, you know. But I think that we'll get competitive people, and that we'll be able to stay at the level we are now. We're certainly going to strive for that, and I hope so. We'd like to be with the best in all of our sports, and we're going to try.
Captain, thanks for spending some time with us, and have fun in that second half.
Thank you.
We're at halftime. We'll return with more halftime activities right after these messages. It's Navy down to Michigan by 5.
Thanks.
That's our score at halftime. Michigan, on the strength of three-point shooting, beating Navy by 5. 24 of Navy's 44 points scored by this man, number 50.
It was a clinic on post play. The big left-hander, although he prefers to turn back into the middle, showed the Wolverines early he can go both ways, but that's still the better risk for the Wolverines to take him baseline. It's almost like a broken record. When the Wolverines did not deny that pass, they paid dearly. And that, folks, was about 8 on the Richter scale. Slow motion takes away the power of that slam dunk.
Robinson tonight is already hit on 9 of 12 shots from the floor. He's 6 for 11 at the foul line. That's his Achilles heel. He has 5 rebounds, 2 block shots. He has a steal and 24 total points. Here's one of his 2 block shots. He's just so graceful and so quick. I think that's what surprised people. When the captains met before tonight's game to meet with the officials at center court, I couldn't help but see guard Thompson of Michigan standing there and looking, sizing up David Robinson, a man 7 feet, probably 2 inches tall. And there is Grant getting a shot blocked by Robinson. He's just a tremendous, tremendous basketball player. A kid who is avid computer fan, builds his own computers, mathematic genius. And remember, this is a guy, Bucky, who's been playing basketball for 5 years, maybe?
If I were Pete Herman, I'd be concerned. Anytime you have a guy that's bigger than you are and smarter than you are, that's a real concern for coaches. I say that in jest. You know, Pete's very happy to have the big fella right where he is, wearing 50 in the middle for Navy.
8 three-point shots made by Michigan, 6 by guard Thompson. But can they keep doing that in the second half?
Well, statistics say no, but in this tournament with the adrenaline flowing and the fact that they're committed, they're really committed to that game and not taking the ball at Robinson, which is really very interesting because he is not in foul trouble, although they are running him pretty good.
We got a whale of a ball game here, and we'll be back with more of our halftime activities, with more of the second half of this game right after these messages. Tonight, North Carolina plays its opening round game against Penn immediately following this one. And a lot of the Carolina fans were able to find disgruntled Middle Tennessee and other fans and get some tickets. Here are other scores around the NCAA today in the Southeast. Looky here, New Orleans over BYU. That's a mild upset. Alabama beats North Carolina A&T. Not surprised by that in the Southeast. In the Midwest, Xavier over Missouri by a point. That's a surprise. Xavier played well in that game, dominated Missouri. That's no fluke. Duke in a low-scoring game against Texas A&M, the winner. The Blue Devils go on. In the West, Kansas State needed overtime and a good overtime run to beat Georgia by 3. And Nevada Las Vegas wins by 25 over Idaho State. On ESPN, you saw Jerry Tarkanian say he was really scared about Idaho State. Marshall loses to TCU. And earlier today, Notre Dame beat Tennessee State. This NCAA tournament first round has gotten some great matchups and some great games. I'm interested in finding out who you like in this tournament so far.
Well, I just have a sneaky feeling that Alabama, not just because they've won already, but they've got those 4 senior guards and a catalyst player in Derek McKee. I like their region in terms, I think, if it comes down and the seeds hold up, they will play Georgetown in the final, and I think those four senior guards will be able to handle the Hoya press. And if they can do that, I think you can beat Georgetown, especially this year. I think Thompson's done a marvelous job, but except for Reggie Williams, they're not a great scoring team. If you solve their press, you can beat them. I think Alabama can do that.
Defense still a key for this tournament. Is that the one thing you need coming in?
Oh, sure. Now, here's Michigan now. This is the best shooting team Michigan has ever had, field goal and free throw. And yet, you know, we're asking the question, can they sustain this against the inside play and the percentage play of Navy? That's always the key.
That's the key, and that's what we're going to find out. Can Michigan do it? Will Navy rise behind David Robinson and write another chapter in his career? We'll be back in a moment. It's the 1987 NCAA Basketball Championship from the Charlotte Coliseum in Charlotte, North Carolina. It's the Michigan Wolverines versus the Midshipmen of Navy. Tonight's game is brought to you in part by Rawlings Sporting Goods Company, maker of the official ball of the NCAA Basketball Championships, and by Pizza Hut, America's favorite pizza place.
NCAA Championship Basketball is brought to you by Miller Lite. For great taste, there's only one light beer. Oldsmobile quality, feel it, at your Greater Detroit Olds dealer. The more you've got to do, the more you need True Value Hardware stores. We've got what it takes.
After 20 minutes of play, Michigan leads Navy by 5. David Robinson, the big force for Navy. Halftime statistics, here they are. 35 shots for Michigan, 31 for Navy. You see the shooting percentages, the free throws, the three-point shots.
They're shooting 10 for 16 from three-point and 50% from the foul line combined, both teams. Amazing.
It really is. Turnovers. Navy started to turn it over as they grew tired in the second, towards the end of the first half.
The 12 fouls
dominating the boards.
12 fouls by Michigan, indicating the strong inside game by Navy, putting the pressure down inside with Michigan really elected not to do. David Robinson now 12th all-time scorer in the NCAA, just Michael Brooks of LaSalle and Wayman Tisdale of Oklahoma ahead of him. If he can stay alive in this tournament, he's going to finish in the top 10. There's that inside foul trouble for the Wolverines, trying to contend with Robinson. So quick, so talented, and Navy has perfected ways to get it to him. I think what happened, Navy got caught up in that faster tempo, and they forgot about Robinson. As well as he runs the floor, he really didn't get set up. You have to remember, the guards go from the head of the key to the head of the key, but those big guys have to truck baseline to baseline. That's considerably more mileage.
This says it all. Three-point shooting for Michigan has accounted for 24 of their 49 first-half points. For Navy, David Robinson has 24 points to equal their three-pointers and 5 rebounds. But Navy is down 5. Remember now, guard Thompson is used to shooting three-pointers. He went 8-for-9 with three-pointers against Illinois Chicago, had 32 points, his career high. Here we go. Navy starts with the ball at the start of the second half. The possession arrow points towards Michigan's end of the floor. So in case of a jump ball, Michigan will gain possession. The shot clock has not been a factor in this game. The pace has been furious. And that should tell on David Robinson as well. Rice with a foul inside that he'd like to have back.
Now, coming out of timeouts and right after the half, you look at the first couple of possessions, you begin to see what the coach has instructed. And that appeared that time to be going away from Robinson. Robinson drawing the defensive pressure. Backcourt scoring. No surprise. 37-10, Wolverines.
Three-point shot, the lucky bounce to Wojcik.
Wojcik wanted to throw that lob. Grant.
Haven't had one tonight.
That's because Grant's been in Wojcik's face.
The tip goes to Carl Lieber.
It's hard to believe he broke a Larry Bird high school rebounding record in Indiana. But then you look at Larry Bird, it's hard to believe he's a great basketball
That's
player.
Right. Navy's in that zone again. Oh, my goodness, Dark Thompson goes again. 23 points for him.
Deja vu. Inside for Navy. Long range for the Wolverines.
Wojcik with his first.
That's also the first time that Robinson has kicked that ball out.
He'll go right back with it again and miss again. But look at Navy control the boards.
That's your play.
Navy's ball.
Robinson drifted a little bit that time. Got the ball in the post, kicked it back out, and then he came out of traffic. I'm sure Pete Herman wants him to stay down inside.
Liebert gets fouled. Uh-oh, it's going to go against number 55, I believe. Mark Hughes. And that is four on Hughes. So he's in foul trouble, the Michigan big man, with 18 and a half minutes still remaining in the game.
Loy Vaught coming in quickly. That's part of the percentage of having an inside game. You put great pressure, you get to the second line players because of personal fouls on the first line players. It's not pretty, but it's an effective way to play. That's one of the things the three-point shot, hopefully, was introduced to reduce that kind of traffic jam underneath. Phil Frieda, by the way, hits the three-point shot at this distance. He thinks it's been a tremendous boost to the game. It's great for the fans, exciting finishes. And he's been in a few.
Not to mention what it's done for his team tonight. Grant's pass was deflected. That's why it caromed off the board like that. This is Antoine Joubert. And guard Thompson's going to get a lot of attention. Maybe kick the ball, so it'll be Michigan's ball over on the sideline.
It's almost like Pete Herman, starting in his own, was trying to determine whether or not they were going to start hot before he showed his defense. Maybe zoning on baseline out of bounds.
They're swinging Thompson around over here to this side, on the near side. See, he's wide open. There he is. Navy's ball.
Guard Thompson with a miss, but did you see who was coming at him from the baseline? Look at the cheerleader, Bill Frieder. Tremendous rebuilding year after back-to-back Big Ten championships.
The game has slowed down. It's more to Navy's pace now.
Good point.
Robinson can't get the basket. Thompson again.
He's worth a little defensive attention.
He's now hit on 8 of 11. Robinson will get it. Will it count? Says Navy. Will it count? Yes, the official. Did you see him drag that out for the dramatic effect?
Yeah, but he really has to take a split second and find a defense. That was nearly a charge. Guard Thompson, in addition to his awesome display of 8 for 11 from three-point range, was in perfect defensive position that time. It appeared to me Robinson ran right over him. Robinson knows the second he catches that ball, traffic is going to accumulate in his area code. He really needs to take a look before he makes a move. The defense doesn't have to give the man with the ball time and distance. They just have to be there first. Oh, what a play. What hands.
Michigan sending a bunch of people to the boards to get those rebounds, and it's worked effectively here at the start of the second half. They still lead by 5. Rice. Does this slower pace, Bucky, help David Robinson?
I don't know. He does not look as intense as he was early when the pace was hectic. I'm really not sure why. Sometimes those tremendous bursts of adrenaline take a lot out of him. But he has not been assertive in the second half. There he is again with the customary grabbing of the trunks.
Loy Vaught that time with a block shot. Second half in the Midwest region.
San Diego is still beating Auburn, this time by four. Here's David Robinson with his 28.
Navy spreading that 2-3 zone, almost defying Michigan to go down inside. They're really out there trying to cover the shot, which leaves a lot open underneath. But when you go underneath, you have to contend with Robinson. It's a good gamble for Pete Herman.
Guard Thompson is putting on a show.
They're going to start calling him Trey Thompson.
9 of 12. Off Michigan hands, it'll be Navy's ball.
You always have to wonder, though, when the whole premise is the three-point shot. I haven't seen a guy that excited without jumper cables on his chest. Did you see three?
There's the three-point shooting. 17 shots taken by the shooter. And it's contagious. Navy's tried him now. That's the third that Wojcik's tried in this half. I wonder if Pete Herman's happy with that at all. There's an inside point. They're very rare. But Michigan just got two against David Robinson.
He's just not assertive, not defensively, not on the boards. And I don't know why.
Maybe he's laying back a little bit for another run. Who knows? But David Robinson hasn't been himself in the first 5 minutes. Michigan's up by 10. Michigan is living by the jump shot. 10-point lead over Navy now, a lead that was 5, but there's a story in itself. See the rim? It's bent. Yes, it is. And officials here in the arena are going to have to fix it. This man has been setting it on fire from outside. Guard Thompson, who has 9 three-point shots now in 12 attempts. He has been scorching the nets. All they got to do is work it around, find him open, and there it goes. He's on fire.
He had a big game in the NCAA last year at Syracuse. He had 23 points and 8 assists in the big Navy win at Syracuse.
Carl Liebert just fixed the rim by running up and shoving it back up into place.
He'll do the same thing on a submarine someday. Just kick that torpedo tube and it'll work.
It'll work.
That's what they take all those math courses for at Annapolis. So we got a Band-Aid on the rim, but I don't know how many of those hammers it's going to take. I think the key is that dunk came right through David Robinson's front yard. And that will sting his manhood, I think. He's not pleased with that at all.
What do you do with Guard Thompson? You go maybe boxing one, something like that?
Well, yeah. Breeder says he has been used to every defense in the Big Ten. The combinations of Navy have been mostly man for man and straight 2-3. I said early in the second half, it's worth a gamble. A diamond in one, a triangle in two. They ought to make somebody else show something. This guy's lighting it up.
Here is the dunk. Put the rim to our left out of commission. It came from Loy Vaught. And you can see the rim stayed there. Now, I don't know what's going to happen the next time that rim gets bumped, but it's something to look forward to. Robinson really squared himself up that time.
Yeah, but he's firing and falling back, Frank. Navy needs him assertive on that board. One of the things he usually does is follow the ball well. For whatever reason, that kind of intensity just isn't there.
The rebound gets away and there's Vaught to follow it up. David Robinson clenches his fist and holds him up to his eyes. His mistake.
Vaught giving the Wolverines a big lift off the bench.
He really is, isn't he? Off balance that time, one-handed. Robinson has 32.
They better go in because Robinson is about, he shoots it at 15 feet. By the time it goes in, he's at 25 feet. There will be no offensive rebounds. He misses.
This time the rim stays up. Bryce on the dunk.
Michigan now showing an inside game of its own against a very porous Navy defense.
They brought that Navy defense out, didn't they? Wojcik will try for four. It still can't find the mark. Antoine Gilbert. It's catchy.
We got an epidemic out there.
That's his first field goal.
Nobody on the Michigan team thinks they can miss a good timeout.
Pete Herman has to call it. Michigan. Michigan coming close to running away with this basketball game. You can see the time remaining. Michigan leads 69 to Navy's 56. Michigan leads by 13 points. They have outscored Navy 17 to 8 in the last 4 minutes. The rim's been taking some punishment as well. First, it came from Loy Vaught on this driving dunk down the baseline. The rim stayed down.
Superb pass, too, that time by guard Thompson, who's second in assists on this team. This was a set play over the top of a flat-footed Navy defense. Rice, Glenn Rice at 6'7", the sophomore, buries it.
There's the telling statistic, 17-8 Michigan over the last 4 minutes.
And it has been the development of an inside game by Michigan. Look at Robinson firing and falling back.
18 shots taken by Navy this half. 18 missed shots this half. Navy has 16 of them. 18 misses. Navy has 16 of them. Robbins. First with the steal and then the drop.
Are you kidding me? Looks like a bus moves like a greyhound. How tall do you like your point guard?
I was going to say, you need a 7'1" guard.
12 and a half minutes to go here.
Come on,
this is the Charlotte Coliseum in Charlotte, North Carolina, where Michigan threatened and running away with this game against Navy. They led by 5 at the half, 49-44. And now you see they are up 69-58 with just over 12 minutes to go. I'm Frank Herzog with Bucky Waters. We have seen two stellar individual performances tonight. The first you'd expect from David Robinson of Navy, 34 points so far. And the second, well, you kind of wondered if it would happen. Guard Thompson, who plays guard for Michigan, has hit on 9 of 12 three-pointers. The three-pointers have been the difference for Michigan. Robinson is keeping Navy in the game. He's got 36 now. Walking over to Navy on the turnover.
Michigan has had very few turnovers because they are not very fancy with that ball. They're working one or two passes, and that man, Bill Breeder, wants it on the glass, preferably from guard Thompson.
Navy with 4 and unanswered points, almost 6. For Robinson.
An exhausted David Robinson.
Capacity crowd here in Charlotte has seen a great matchup between these two teams, the 8th and 9th seeds in the NCAA East. Michigan finished 5th in the Big Ten. Navy the champion of the Colonial Athletic Association.
Navy now going man for man against that spread 2-3 zone. Michigan established an inside game. There just wasn't any movement at all in the Navy zone. And they went from three-point shooting to just carving the inside of the Navy defense. I think this is a good move by Pete Herman.
This is guard Thompson on the near side of the ball who's been doing all the three-point damage. Cliff Reese has drawn the defensive assignment against him. The first lob of the night attempted to David Robinson, and the ball thrown a little bit too high. The basket got in his way.
Well, it's one of the few times tonight Doug Wojcik, the superb guard, did not have Grant right in his face. Wojcik throws that lob about as well as you can. Of course, a guy like Robinson on the other end can make your mistakes look pretty good. Michigan now spreading the floor, taking a little more time with the ball.
They're going to use some clock. They've got a 7-point lead. What do you think?
I don't know. It looks like they want Navy to play man for man. But they're playing so well. Their momentum is so good. You have to wonder about getting cute with it.
Jobert can't get it to drop. Carl Liebert will get the foul. That's 2 on Liebert.
Antoine Jobert in his senior year. Highly recruited. Big name high school player. Has had a good career at Michigan.
Not the outstanding career that a lot of people expected, though, Buck.
Yeah, that's part of the problem with the high school expectations. He's a tweener in college. Moved to forward this year to accommodate the fine backcourt of Thompson and Grant. But he's had a nice career. Michigan has done well. Two Big Ten titles, an NIT title, and that's a tough league.
Michigan shows like they want to put a little pressure on.
Well, soft, but they are extending it again. I can't say enough about the job Grant's doing on Wojcik. He's making every pass an adventure for him.
Liebert inside. That was a pretty play.
Well, he's not graceful, but he gets it done.
Hughes is wide open. Man snuck inside. Who was that masked man?
Well, Robinson went for the block, and when he comes off that defensive board, Navy is very, very small. So when he goes for the reject, he almost has to get it, or he leaves Navy very vulnerable for the second shot.
Robinson gets 40. He is 5 points away from his career high that he had against Kentucky and earlier against James Madison. Guess what his career high is in block shots?
10.
14.
That was close.
Yeah. Whistle inside, and it's going to be Dave Wojcik who gets called for holding up Grice. North Carolina coach Dean Smith, whose team lost in the ACC tournament championship game to North Carolina State, a little worried about momentum now. His team plays the next game against Penn. Excuse me, Buck.
Yeah, Penn is 13-13 out of the Ivy League. You've got to expect the Tar Heels to come out a bit peeved. Many pick North Carolina to go all the way and, in fact, be the number one team in the country. I still think, though, that the fact that they won a double overtime game on Saturday against Virginia, lost a double overtime game to North Carolina State in the finals of the ACC tournament, is a lot better preparation for their destiny to possibly win a national championship in this tournament than, say, UNLV just killing three people in their conference tournament out on the field.
We just moved under the 9-minute mark here in the second half. Michigan leads by 6. They led at one point by 13. Grant can't get the three-pointer. Robinson looks like he's starting to come alive again. Three men around David Robinson. The three-point shot. And now Michigan will try to get something going.
Maybe putting it up rather quick without trying to find Robinson.
Almost tipped back in by Navy, tipped back in by Rice.
David Robinson that time never got closer than 30 feet to the basket. He just stood out here on the perimeter, watched one shot, watched two shots.
Wojcik again has not hit from three-point range tonight, and Robinson can't control the offensive board. Look at Jobert feed him. Foul on the play. He'll go to the line.
The Wolverines in transition, as we said at the top. They're not a blazing team, but they're better when they're running. With the three guards, they're very good in the open floor. They're also not a big team, but they're the second best rebounding team in the Big Ten.
Gentlemen, two shots.
2 for 9 from three-point land for the Middies. Michigan, 13 for 19. But I think the real story now is David Robinson. He is not playing both ends of the floor.
Bucky, another significant thing. Dave Wojcik has gone to the Navy bench. With 4 fouls, he's going to get a rest. So Navy has brought in backup Neil Fenton, who must fill in. But you can expect Navy, I think, to go back to a zone, huh?
Yeah, well, Fenton's had some big nights, too. He went 6 for 7 against James Madison in the tournament. So he's capable. But what they need right now is ball handling to beat that pressure. Now Grant's going to pick up Fenton. So far, no good for Navy. He was stripped. Boy, the Wolverines are like in a frenzy on that defense. They're looking at Fenton, who's a little insecure with that ball, and it's like Barracuda's in the tub.
Uh-oh.
Good night.
Timeout.
Wojcik's got to go in there if he's going to play in a wheelchair.
Navy gets the timeout to avoid disaster. We've got 7.5 minutes left to play in this game. Our score, the Michigan Wolverines 80, the Middies of Davies 66. There's the score in this basketball game. Michigan has gone back to a 14-point lead. That's their biggest of the night. The difference, the reason, first of all, guard Thompson with a steal and a score off Neil Fenton. Fenton came into the ball game to replace Dave Wojcik, to give him a rest. And there's the second turnover by Fenton. And look at this one. Cradle off his tummy and dunk it for Rice. Another score in tonight's NCAA action. From the Midwest, with 3 minutes left to play, Auburn starting to pull away from San Diego. San Diego has led throughout that game. Dave Wojcik is back into the ballgame. He got about a minute and a half's worth of rest.
It was very unfortunate, and I'm not sure if it was by design or not, but Michigan had not really pressed until Fenton came in the game.
Wojcik again tries the three-pointer, and he still hasn't scored tonight. And he's about 0-for-7 at three-point range. Robinson. Somebody reaching in. I believe it's Navy.
Robinson very emotional. Pete Herman studying, trying to do something to solve that pressure. Trying to get some offense.
The foul goes against forward Derek Turner from Navy. That's his fourth. Michigan now with 7 minutes left to go and a 14-point lead, I would think, will really use that clock.
Well, this is where the three-guard offense comes together. Remember, this is a fine Michigan free-throw shooting team, the best in the school's history, along with their field goal shooting.
Something we should watch, Doug Wojcik is playing guard Thompson. Wojcik from Navy has 4 personal fouls. Thompson has lit it up tonight for 31 points, 1 point off his career high. He's got the ball right now.
Shot clock at 10. Boy, is that disheartening. They keep you on defense that long, which is not a skill that Michigan had shown us tonight. They were putting it up very quickly. No turnovers, but quick shots. Now they're showing they can use the clock as well.
Cliff Reese comes back with his first field goal of the second half. He had 10 points in the first. We've got 6 minutes to go. You see the clock, lower right-hand corner there. Scoreboard says it all, 14-point Michigan lead.
Boy, this is tough for Navy. It takes Robinson right out of the game.
Grant.
Well, Grant has been outstanding. We're talking about guard Thompson, and Grant has just done it defensively every second he's been out there. He's had the tough defensive assignment. He's passed well. He's rebounded. He has a reject. And now he's showing his shooting range. We talked before about he's had several good seasons at Michigan, but has not been up to par in the NCAA tournament. He certainly has resolved that with this opening round game.
I'm reminded of the old joke. Who's buried in Grant's tomb? Navy.
Very good. Very good.
5.5 minutes to go in the ballgame. Navy is down by 16 points.
They had 44 points at the half. Only 24 now with just about 5 minutes to go.
Robinson with 42. Michigan has done an outstanding job tonight. 9 three-pointers from guard Thompson. 2 more from Gary Grant, along with 22 points, an inspired playmaker play. 18 points by Glenn Rice, the one front court player to have double figures tonight. Bodies fly.
Boy, guard Thompson has some acceleration. Wojcik, who is not blessed with great speed, just was very smart, got to good position.
3 fouls now on guard Thompson. Here are some other pairings for Saturday. The Horned Frogs of TCU against the Irish of Notre Dame. Kansas State out west against Nevada of Las Vegas. In the Midwest, upset winner Xavier against Duke, the Blue Devils. And New Orleans, upset winners earlier today against Alabama.
Looking at the East, the TCU-Notre Dame game. Two patient teams, two ball-controlled teams. And looking ahead in the brackets, if North Carolina can win in, against Penn and advance that far, they're the kind of teams that have given the Tar Heels problems. The NC States, Notre Dame previously, teams that really control tempo have been difficult for the Heels.
Robinson now has 44 points off the offensive rebound there. He's one away from his career best. Ironically, his career best in their last loss to Kentucky.
That was 13 games ago, an 11-point loss in Rupp Arena.
They're down 11 now with 4:40 left to play, and they ain't done, I'll tell you that. Especially him. He's come back to life, and he's got a new career high, 46 points. Timeout, Michigan. Bill Frieder wants to talk this time. He sees things starting to go the Middies' way. We've got 4.5 minutes left to play. Michigan leads 84 to Navy 75. Great shooting by Michigan, and a well-conceived offense has put the Wolverines out on top by 9 points. David Robinson in a great performance tonight. Here is the bucket that gave him his career best 46th point.
Well, coming into this game in six previous NCAA games, he was averaging 25 points and 12 rebounds. A smooth shooting stroke, but they still need him on that offensive board.
He's taken 30 shots tonight. Made 19 of them.
This Navy team has some NCAA experience. Last year, they beat Tulsa by 12, Syracuse by 11 in Syracuse, won over Cleveland State, and then lost to Duke in the final 8 game.
Bucky almost as enlightening to that is, though. While he has 46 points and career best, he only has 8 rebounds tonight and only 2 block shots. He has more steals than blocks. Now Reese gets called for the personal foul.
4:24 to go, 9 down, and Navy is extending their defense. And this could be feast or famine. When you're pressing 3 guards, the capability that the Michigan guards have is either going to get worse and in a hurry, or you're going to get yourself back in the game. But Pete Herman has no choice.
This is where they need the 3-point shooter. Navy's going to get back into it. And this is where Michigan needs those 3 guards. That's where they come into real prominence here because they handle the ball so well. You start to think about people to foul on Michigan.
A very good free throw shooting.
Well, there's nobody but Loy Vaught, number 30, to foul. And he's not in the ball game. Rice now has 20 points. Again, he leads the front court players in scoring. 3-point attempt. They found a 3-point shooter in Neil Fenton.
As long as he doesn't have to bring up the ball against that quickness. Remember, he went 6-for-7 from 3-point land in the conference game. In fact, it was the same game that David Robinson shot his only 3-point shot, a 40-footer, a buzzer beater, to win for Navy.
I tell you, it looked like they had won the last game ever played, Bucky. The stands emptied up onto their shoulders. He went as the crowd danced for 10 minutes.
That a strong crowd. You don't pick up 7-footers every day.
What a moment. And the interesting thing about that is Navy the next day in the tapes kept looking at the play. He wanted to look over and over again, not to see himself shoot it, but to see the reaction of his teammates when the ball went in. He was delighted by it. They tried the lob for only the second time tonight, and it failed again.
That's the kind of offensive rebounding we've been talking about. Tearing and falling back. That time he ran it down, did he?
48 points for David Robinson.
He's gotten a second wind. I don't know where he got it from, but
we talked about it in the opening of our broadcast, Bucky, and it has come true. What we said, you said, if you let David Robinson get his 50, then you beat him with your guards. And that's what Michigan's done.
Well, when he had his 45 in Lexington, Kentucky, the backcourt total was 4 points. 2 by Wojcik and 2 by Jones, I think. But it was a total of 4-point production from the backcourt.
Look at this.
Watch him follow. This is called follow your shot. That ball may have been on the rim. But it was such an awesome play, and it happened so quick, not even Frieder complained. Took a big bite out of that towel, though. He's going to have a ball of lint in his stomach the size of a baseball.
But they have a problem with cats with that, don't they? And he looks the same as he did an hour before the game. He just...
They lead by eight. Clock is moving down to 2 minutes. Time is running out on Navy. And running out on David Robinson's career, don't forget. No foul call. Joubert can't believe it. Bill Kreider can't believe it. Quite frankly, I can't either.
I was expecting to hear Sweet Georgia Brown laying down dribbling. Marcus Haynes, where have you gone? Actually, Joubert shouldn't be dribbling that kind of traffic. That was a lead.
Robinson with a long two-pointer.
Guess who's rebounding?
Guard Thompson. All together. A minute and 35 seconds to go. Michigan in control of the game. They led by three in the early going after Navy seemed to have a spurt. Navy went up by nine, and then suddenly Michigan came back. They took a five-point lead at 44-39. They took a five-point lead into the dressing room, and then they built on it. They took it to 13 points at 69-56.
Antoine Joubert played right there like a hockey player, didn't he? He got nailed, turnover, kept his dribble alive. If he had none, it would have been a walk.
Passed it with the back of his hand. Rice to the line.
A two-shot foul.
One and one.
The official signal two right here.
One, guys.
There would have been a free-for-all had he missed, I'll tell you that.
I wonder how Bill Kreider feels about a team last year in Michigan that was favored to make it into the Final Four. A lot of people talked about a Final Four team and didn't. And this year, a team that finished fifth in the Big Ten suddenly has found success in its first NCAA game. Must be delighted.
Yeah, these are the fun years. It's when they put the pressure on you where you almost can't live up to expectations. They're the ones that put holes in coaches' bellies.
Now the quick foul, and that's it for Dave Wojcik. He's fouled out of the ball game. His fifth foul comes with a minute and 4 seconds left to play.
I think one of the keys in the end of this game is when they tried to rest Wojcik, and Fenton came in the ball game, and it appeared by design that Bill Kreider, sensing Fenton not a confident ball handler, came down, extended the defense, got two quick turnovers, and that really opened it up to give the Wolverines some breathing room.
The ovation you see for Dave Wojcik, the point guard at Navy, ending his collegiate career here tonight. He did not score. He had four rebounds and a several assists. Carl Liebert, the other senior, will come back into the ball game to join David Robinson.
Started 100 straight games for Navy. The captain. Wheeling, West Virginia. Just today, wants the coach.
Liebert will commit personal foul. Here's an interesting story, too. Carl Liebert, before the championship game in the CAA tournament, left a note for each one of the media people who covered Navy over his career, thanking them for being kind, for writing about Navy, and making his career so special.
Touch of class.
Guard Thompson.
He had a good start this season, too, Liebert. At 18 against NC State in that opening tip-off classic.
He now has a new career high. He just hit it with that free throw. 33 points for Guard Thompson in a great performance tonight. It'll be Michigan's ball. 54 seconds left to play.
Navy needs only three-point shots. They've got to pass up layups to take it past the line.
Reach in foul. On Fenton. We welcome you back who've been watching NCAA action around the country. We are in Charlotte. I'm Frank Herzog with Bucky Waters, and we've seen Michigan tonight dominate a Navy team, take over midway through the first half, build their lead up to 16 points, and now they're coasting to a 91-80 victory with 50 seconds left to go.
Outstanding performances tonight by the man who's at the line, Gary Grant, the playmaker guard, who now has 23 points. And the big shooting by guard Thompson, who hit on 9 of 12 three-point attempts. He now has 33 points, a new career high. Throw in another 21 points from forward Glenn Rice. And Michigan has put together another great performance to stay alive in this tournament. Grant for the bottom.
Well, that's one of the few mistakes that Grant has made tonight. Michigan, of course, does not want to foul. They don't want to stop that clock. They can live with a couple of field goals with this 13-point lead.
Here are the career stats now for David Robinson. His rebounds, his points. He's averaged 20.9 points a game, 516 block shots. Tonight, he hit on 20 of 32 shots. 6 for 12 from the free throw line. He had 12 rebounds, 2 block shots, 3 steals, and 48 points. 50 points. Robinson got his 50, Bucky.
What a great way to finish individually. It's the end of the year for Navy, but they had a wonderful year. Considering the talent, a new coach. They also lost a very fine player right before the start of the season, like two games before, Nathan Bailey, for an internal problem. So they've had a great year.
Final score, Auburn held on against San Diego 62-61.
Sonny Smith in his post-game press conference will convince everybody with that slick tongue of his that he blew him away.
Grant now with 26 points to go along with guard Thompson's 33. Robinson goes for 52. Lob. Blocked three-point shot, and it's Antoine Jobert who will throw the touchdown pass. Whoa, he did the rim good that time, didn't he?
I believe I could dunk it on that one. It's supposed to snap back up, but that's the second time a Wolverine has hit that rim with such authority that it didn't go back up. Well, bring one of those Navy guys out there.
Got to get a tall guy to dunk it back up.
The judge. Antoine Jobert.
David Robinson, I believe, is going to come out of the ballgame. Let's see. We'll listen to the ovation he gets. What a great career for David Robinson. Standing ovation.
Right on the money. Had to wait a little bit for it, DePaul. Number 50. The end of an era.
50 points for number 50. 12 rebounds, 2 block shots, 3 steals. They're on their feet. Meanwhile, they can't get the rim back up. If you're wondering, officials here do have a spare backboard that between games they can haul out and put into place, because this one obviously has got a problem. While they try to get it back up, we'll take a break. 2 seconds left. Michigan 97, Navy 82. They're going to play the final 2 seconds of this game with a broken rim. You see it there. Navy has the ball, and they're going to shoot at the other end. And they've only got 2 seconds to get the shot off. So officials will take the half-hour break between games to try to replace this rim. I overheard one of the workmen say, I think it's a busted spring. I think that's the least of it, a busted spring. Michigan has substituted for its seniors, with the exception of Antoine Jobert. He's still there. Navy has substituted for their seniors, and this will be it. The last shot, and it's all over. And in the meantime, a great career has finished as well in college basketball. That one there, 2,669 points, 1,300 rebounds, 500 block shots. Michigan wins it, 97-82. David Robinson has joined us here at the Charlotte Coliseum. Frank Herzog, Bucky Waters, a 50-point performance tonight, but it just wasn't enough.
Well, we wanted to come out and we wanted to establish ourselves and not let them score too much. And 49 points in the first half is way too much. So they hit a lot of good shots in the first half. And second half, I think we broke down a little bit and gave them too many easy shots.
What a great career. Any thoughts now as you stand here, you realize the college career is over?
I know I've had a lot of fun, and I think beyond all the awards that I get and everything, I was just thinking the biggest thing that's going to stay in my mind about my 4 years in the Navy is my team. I mean, we've been the best of friends throughout the 4 years, and that's made the biggest difference.
It's been a magical experience, hasn't it?
Oh, definitely has.
David, you look like you got a little tired after that initial burst. I mean, you came out so strong, and it looked like the emotion of it drained you a bit.
Yeah, I think early we were all real pumped up and wanted to come out and wanted to establish ourselves. We got the 10-point lead, and I was a little tired there, and I had to get my second win. Once I got my second win, I was all right.
You know, all that 3-point shooting was out of respect for you. They didn't want to bring the ball down inside. Had to be a little frustrating watching all those bombs.
Yeah, they shot real well. Guard Thompson was hitting everything, seemed like. And, you know, that's real tough to recover from those.
David, congratulations on a superb career, a great job for Navy, and I know you're looking forward to a little more basketball along the way.
All right, thanks a lot.
All right, thank you. David Robinson from Navy. For Bucky Waters, this is Frank Herzog saying so long from the Charlotte Coliseum. Once again, the final score, the Michigan Wolverines 97, the Midshipmen of Navy 82. This has been an NCAA Productions telecast.